When I think about the way we used to be, when I think about the things you took from me, I know.
Hey everyone, I hope you're all well today. Excuse the state of me, but we literally just got back and I wanted to get all of my thoughts and ideas into a video as soon as possible before I forgot them. So yeah, I mean, I definitely still smell of campfire and I'm definitely not properly cleaned, but I really wanted to do this video, so here goes. It's also raining a lot outside, which is A, brilliant in that we missed the rain when we were camping, but B, it's quite noisy, so if you can hear pitter-patters, it's the rain. Yeah, I hope you enjoy this video. The things I'm gonna talk about relate specifically to our camping trip, but to be honest, a lot of them will apply for any self-catering holiday or if you're taking a camper van. Lots of these things are applicable basically to other holidaying situations where you're outside of your family home. I'm gonna split the video up into a couple of different sections and talk you through, yeah, the different products and little tips and tricks we did along the way to help us. So let's start with food. The main thing I'd advise is to have a good idea of the meals that you are wanting to cook out there. So depending on how many days you're gonna be there, just have a rough idea for breakfast, lunch, and dinner and then plan accordingly. I chose meals that avoided any need for plastic packaged food. So for example, eggs for breakfast, porridge oats, and then I pre-made some tortilla wraps. Before our trip, I paid a visit to a couple of stores and did a couple of online orders. So I went to get things like bread from the bakery, went to the deli to get a little bit of cheese, things like rice and pasta. I stocked up on from a shop called Zero Waste Club. I just placed an order online and got a big delivery of whole grain brown rice and pasta. And that saw us through some nice meals out there as well. All my fruit and veg I got loose from the supermarket as usual. Also visited our local package free shop to get things like sun-dried tomatoes and some porridge oats and a couple of treats that we had. So we had like a snack jar with chocolate buttons and Brazil nuts because you always need like some sweet treats when you're camping. Milk-wise, we just took the milk that we get delivered from the milkman and I just decanted it into a kilner jar with a sturdy lid. The other thing we took is, of course, reusable water bottles, which we just kept filling up from the water on site, which was super useful. And then I took lots of beeswax wrap to eliminate any need for cling film or tin foil. Plates and cutlery and bowls and cups and all of that stuff was a combination of things that we just brought from home and things that the campsite already had. I didn't use any plastic, disposable cutlery or plates or cups. I grabbed the kids' stainless steel straws, which they had a lot of fun drinking juice through in the morning. The only bit of plastic wrap food we had was a little bit of halloumi, some mozzarella, and some marshmallows that I found left over from Jack's party. As for toys, I took the kids' usual sort of go-to wooden toys, so some trains and some wooden little vegetables that they love to cut up. But to be honest, they just had so much fun in nature, which is the best toy ever. And they really didn't need many toys. I also took some paints for Jack and some paper. Yeah, they just had loads of fun playing in the meadow and meeting the other kids. Toiletry-wise, this one's really simple because I just basically grabbed the things that we might use at home, but maybe just decanted them. So for example, I took a little bit of coconut oil in a stainless steel tin, and I took my bamboo toothbrush, I took my Geoganics toothpaste, took some shampoo beauty cubes, which didn't actually use in the end. Sam likes to use those. I just wash my hair with water. I didn't wear makeup, but on my birthday, I just popped a little bit of this. I think it's from Herb Apothecary, if I can pronounce it. I get mine from a place called Akala. I just popped a little bit of that on my face, just to feel a little bit special on my birthday. We didn't take any shower gel. We don't have that at home anyway. We just took a soap bar. We took a roll of Who Gives a Crap toilet paper, which we love and subscribe to, nappies. So we did successfully cloth nappy Sonny whilst we were away. It helped because he is potty training at the moment, so doesn't wear as many nappies. I just took a bunch with me. And then with the dirty ones, I just put them in the wet bags that I brought with me. And then I just left them outside the tent, so they didn't make inside the tent smell or anything. Plus they're in the wet bags, so they wouldn't have smelled anyway. And then I just dealt with them once I got home as usual. Same goes for cloth wipes. I just took loads of cloth wipes with me, wet them once we were there, then just chucked them in the wet bag once they were used, and then again just washed them all when I got back here. Super simple. We were away for slightly under a week, but if we'd have been away for any longer, I would have just either gone to a local laundrette and I probably would have phoned ahead just to check they'd have been okay with me coming in with a load of washable nappies, Or I would have just asked the campsite if I could have used their washing facilities, which is normally what I do when we go and stay at places. But yeah, totally doable to travel and use cloth nappies. The only issue is that the cloth nappies take up quite a lot of space. That's probably the main downside of them. I've probably forgotten something. Jack's joined us for the end of the video. Did you enjoy camping? What was your favourite bit?
Seeing my friends.
Seeing your friends? Oh. So yeah, we totally managed to have a pretty plastic-free camping trip. Just with a tiny bit of planning, it is totally possible. Any questions, please leave them in the comments below. I really hope you enjoyed this video, and please subscribe, and I'll see you next week. Thanks, guys. Bye. There was something going on, that shade of death.